This started amid a global pandemic with 11 young men in red and white playing inside empty stadiums in Florida and Chicago. This started with games against Aruba, Suriname, and Haiti. This started in a group text chat between teammates, typing one word again and again. Qatar. 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 Canada's men took the longest road in an attempt to qualify for their first World Cup in 36 years. And the whole way they revealed a joy that isn't found at the destination. Joy isn't effort. Joy isn't brotherhood. And joy is grabbing a country's attention. In all of it, the joy is the journey. Their collective journey started long before this, because what bonds these players is where they came from. Not out of a single place, but rising from a shared purpose. Families from Haiti, Serbia, Colombia, Portugal, England, West Africa, and many more, who all built new lives here. But qualifying Canada to a World Cup wasn't their common language. All these young men with their gifts, and their first common language was soccer, and their first joy was playing together. There's long been a desire to see Canada's men in the World Cup, and there's long been a pledge to cheer long and loud if only Canada could get all the way there. 36 years is a long time to want and wait and not see it happen. But this team's joy is unburdened by the past. Historic wins in Haiti, Honduras, and El Salvador. Fighting back in the U.S. and in Mexico before beating the Mexicans and the Americans in the Canadian cold. After a generation of succumbing to other countries' environments and other countries' tricks, they couldn't handle our talent in our home and native land. And that's when the joy of young men became the joy of a nation. Their smiles and their happiness playing together triggered something. A tingle at the end of fingertips became breath rising in the chest, and now it's voices shouting out loud and carrying across this big country. Canada's men are going to the World Cup. And this is the flag you'll be waving in November. It's their flag. It's your flag. It's our flag. But there's something more. All of their flags are now our flags too. If their joy is now our joy, then all of their journeys are becoming our journey. Because now it's time to make good on our promise and rejoice without holding back. Because this is the world's biggest stage, and these young men, Canada's young men, are not simply going to Qatar to participate. They made history on this continent. They earned their way and reshaped the balance of power.
The Canadians, the class of CONCACAF's World Cup qualifying.
What can they do when the world is watching? Watching, watching. The joy and the journey are far from over.